In this video, I'll demonstrate manual investigations in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, like when analysts have incidents assigned to them and they want to dig into the details, or an analyst wants to explore more information about a specific file or machine. The Incidents queue is the starting point for threat investigations. It provides high-level information about each incident, like the impacted machines, the sources that contributed alerts to it, and the severity. Incidents optimize your time by helping you to triage, investigate, and remediate related alerts together. Selecting an incident opens a side pane with similar information, but it also shows the individual alerts involved in the incident. To see all the details, however, I'll need to open the incident page. The Alerts tab shows all the alerts that are involved in this incident. In this case, there are several. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint correlates alerts into incidents a few different ways, and the Linked By column shows how each made it into the incident. You'll notice that proximate time is one of the more common ways alerts are linked to incidents. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint correlates alerts when they occur on the same machine around the same time. It might also correlate alerts involving the same file across multiple machines or a similar structure, and analysts can manually link alerts to an incident as they expand an investigation. Select an alert without clicking the link to open it to see the alert side pane. There's a lot of detail here, including the detection source, activity dates and times, alert category, detailed description, and of course, a reason for linking it to the incident. Scroll down further to see the machine related to this alert, other related alerts, the alert's history, and any comments about it. Back to the incident at hand, the Machines tab shows the machines involved in this incident. This gets very interesting when there are multiple machines because it can help to better understand the incident's scope or find additional clues to find a root cause. I'll leave you to explore the remaining investigations, evidence, and graph tabs. Their purposes are self-evident. Next, we'll drill into one of the related alerts to continue our investigation. In the Alert side pane, select Open Alert Page to drill down to its details, or just select an alert title, which is linked to the alert page. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint provides a ton of detail about alerts, including the alert context, which is the computer and identity associated with a suspicious behavior, along with the timing, the status of the alert, a description, and some recommended actions for investigating it. Below all of that is the process tree, which shows full details about each process leading up to the alert, including its activity. For example, it'll report when a process creates a file, changes a registry setting, and when Defender for Endpoint detects a threat, like a malware file. Select any item in the process tree to open a side pane containing quite a bit of detail, like execution and file details, including the hash, size, and signer. Scroll down the side pane to understand the number of times this file has been seen worldwide and in your organization. You can even pop open a link to this file's hash on VirusTotal to see who else detected it. This executable file looks to be the culprit in our incident, so I'll select Open File Page to drill into it and continue our investigation. That's next. The File Page provides incredible detail about an executable file. To start with, the Overview tab provides the same information as the file side pane did. The Alerts tab goes on to show all the alerts associated with this file. That list provides valuable context to aid in your investigation. The Observed in Organization tab provides even more context. It lists the machines this file has been observed on, and you can even use the interactive timeline to scope it to a date range within the past 6 months. Last, if you're unsure whether the file is malicious, send it for deep analysis. Doing so submits the file to Microsoft Defender for Endpoint for detonation and observation with detailed results provided in a report. We have another video that demonstrates this capability, and we encourage you to watch it in action. In this example, the file is clearly malicious, so I'll stop and quarantine it. Next, we'll continue our investigation by examining a specific machine related to this incident. On the left side of a machine page is details about the machine OS, device health and risk, the number of active incidents, and IP addresses. The Alerts tab lists the alerts related to this machine, which may or may not be related to the incident we're investigating. Valuable clues, nonetheless. And the machine timeline shows events on the machine over time. it's often helpful to filter for certain event types, like process events. To see events within a date range, just draw on the timeline, and the list of events will automatically update. There's a lot more information here, like security recommendations, the software installed on the machine, vulnerabilities related to the OS and other installed software, and any missing updates. There's also an action bar at the top so you can act on the machine. For example, you can isolate it from the network to avoid further infections. Once I'm satisfied that we've dealt with the incident and addressed the alerts linked to it, and taken all required remediation actions, the last step is to resolve it. To do that, select Manage Incident. Then enable Resolve Incident. Choose a classification and determination, leave a comment describing how and why I resolved it, and save my work. The classification will apply to all alerts linked to this incident, if they're not yet classified. This helps to improve the quality of alerts over time, and the comments will document my work for other analysts. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint provides details and resources to help you fully investigate incidents and remediate threats and vulnerabilities. You can learn more about investigations on Microsoft Docs.